developing manufacturing processes takes time and effort. And that is absolutely the truth when it comes to the massive multi-step process that goes to completing gears and putting them into stores. It's also a really good example about why vertical integration is so essential and a massive part of HX50. To get this gear to a stage of completion, if you were to do it out of house with no vertical integration, it would take about 58 times longer than if you did it in-house.
The reason why using a subcontract supply chain is problematic, particularly when you've got something as complicated as gears to produce with, say, 30 stages, is that because nobody can really commit to when the bits are going to arrive on the shop floor with one subcontractor in the process, it's really difficult to coordinate effectively everybody in the chain. So at every stage in that 30-stage process, you find that you're waiting in somebody's queue, getting the work done, and then you go and join somebody else's queue. So the time scales just become really, really unpredictable and elongated, and that's when things are going well. It's not that any of these companies are incapable or are not efficient, it's just fundamentally the process becomes completely disjointed and really, really difficult to manage. So by vertically integrating and doing everything in-house, you've essentially got control of everything and you get to set the priorities. So it dramatically eliminates all of the logistics, the transport, the queuing, the waiting. All of that goes immediately because the gears just go from one step to another under one roof in your own factory.
Now that you understand why creating an in-house production process for the gears is so essential, let's go look at that very last step. It's just been completed, meaning that we are closing the gears chapter. So let's jump over to Geisen, who have been developing this process for us.
Okay, we're going to start some shop feeding trials shortly. So this is what they call an almond strip testing jig. And what it is a jig that represents all the angles of the gear that we want to peen. So we've got one that's perpendicular to the direction of the shop, which represents what we're going to achieve in the root of the teeth.
The reason why we have such complicated processes and quality controls to make aviation grade gears is because if you think of the duty of a pair of gears when they roll together, every time a tooth rolls against its counterpart, it creates very large bending stresses at the root of that tooth. Now those are fundamentally fatigue stresses. It's a bit like taking a paperclip. You can bend it all the way open and it doesn't break, but if you just bend it gently a few times like that, after a specific number of cycles, it'll break at a really low load. And that's what we're trying to protect against with these gear teeth. So we have to be very, very careful about all of the things that influence the fatigue strength of these teeth. Now, one of the tricks that we use is to make sure the surface finish is really, really high quality. We make sure the material is just right. We do all the hardening processes. The very final step that we do is shop peening the root of the tooth. And what that does is it puts some residual compressive stresses into the material at the surface of the root of the tooth. And that means that you've actually got to bend the tooth a little bit further before it sees any surface tensile stresses at all, and that dramatically improves the fatigue life and so the service life of the gear in practice. Once we've got this bit sorted, that's the full end-to-end control of all the manufacturing processes and the quality controls that we need to make all of the aerospace grade gears for HX50.
Really good trip today. Slight little tweak that they got to do to their parameters. They're running towards the top limit. Bring that back to nominal, and we're good. That's the final process of all the gears.
And so with all of the machining operations the measurement operations, the plating operations, the heat treatment operations, and now the shop peening complete, Hill Helicopters is now in a position to manufacture in-house aerospace quality gears. And what this really means for the company is the whole vertical integration strategy works. You can make things faster, more cost effectively, with complete control over the quality and approvals necessary to make aerospace grade parts. We've done it.